तो हेलो दोस्तों, वेलकम टू माय यूट्यूब चैनल। और आज हम बात करेंगे अबाउट मास्टर ऑफ फार्मेसी। इफ यू वांट टू डू योर मास्टर डिग्री फ्रॉम ऑस्ट्रेलिया, तो व्हाट आर द रिक्वायरमेंट, व्हाट आर द यूनिवर्सिटीज आर ऑफरिंग, फी एंड ऑल दिस इज टू डिस्कस। सो मास्टर ऑफ फार्मेसी इज टू टाइप इन ऑस्ट्रेलिया। आई मीन इफ यू कैन, द नेम इज मास्टर ऑफ फार्मेसी एम फार्म, अनदर वन इज एम फिल। सो व्हाट आर द डिफरेंस इन टू दिस टू कोर्स, दिस इज मोस्ट इम्पॉर्टेंट। Many students are choose, they don't know which course they have to choose. If you want to be a registered pharmacist, for example, if you are an overseas pharmacist and you did your bachelor degree from your country and you want to do here in master degree and you want to be a registered pharmacist, you want to went as a pharmacist, then you have to choose Master of Pharmacy M.Pharm. So this course is a 2-year course, and then you have to finish your 1-year internship, then you can be a registered pharmacist. I mean, you will be considered as a local pharmacist. I mean, no need to give you and do the CAPS exam. But another one is a MPhil. So MPhil is those are bachelor degree from Australia. Those are the local students in Australia. After bachelor degree, they can go for PhD directly, but they have to be a certain grade. I mean, they have to be like honors degree, so they can go for directly to the PhD. But some students are not perform. I mean, the grade is not high, so they have to go for first MPhil, and then they can convert it into the PhD. So many local students, those have less marks, they join Master of Pharmacy. I mean MPhil, they join first, then after 1 year or something, they can go for the PhD. So first you have to be the shortlisted the universities. So many universities are offering here the Master of Pharmacy, and you have to choose, you know, there is a certain criteria to choose the university. Like, you know, everyone want to be come here to study and want to get the PR and the job. So PR and job, these are the very important, and if you have PR, you can get very easily job, you know. And in, and so choosing the university, like if you are from a big university and big cities, and so this is a very state to state. Some state they are offering, those are the student I study from their state, they give them the extra mark and they give the sponsorship, so they can get the PR. For example, Tasmania or Western Australia, and you know, all those states are, I mean, they don't have much population, they need the people. So if someone graduate from there, easily they can get PR, even job. But for example, if you come for Sydney or maybe the Melbourne, so here Sydney comes into the NSW state, and they don't offer the sponsorship to the student. So you have to choose the low ranking universities. Low ranking university have the less fee, and there will be a more chance to get job and PR to there. So choose very wisely. And you can choose, but there is some test like MCAT and GAMBAT. Some universities ask, but if you are a registered pharmacist in your country and you are working, you have some experience like 2-3 years, then there is no need. But this is also very university to university. Then English requirement. This is important for IELTS. You have to be a 7 overall or 6.5 each. They consider 6.5 each band and or 7 overall. Or maybe sometimes they give exemption if you have bachelor degree from an institute they are offering in English. I mean, you have to take a letter from your university. For example, if you are from India, Pakistan, Bangladesh, so they can give you a letter that this course was instruction in English, so they can be exemption. But this is not sure for all universities are offering, but some they can, you can have to try. So after finish this 2-year course, then you have to go for a then you'll be registered in the board and pharmacy board, and then you have to go for the 1-year internship. And this is the internship, mostly they are the paid internship here in Australia, so no need to worry. during these 2 years, you can work as a part-time, especially in some pharmacies, like you can be work as a, like technician, pharmacy technician. Mostly they hire those are the students. So all the students are studying pharmacy from year 1 to year 4 or from year 1 to year 2 in Master of Pharmacy M.Pharm. Most of them are working as a technician. So they have some experience and they can have enough money to live for their own expenses. But for fee maybe you required from your own pocket. And then you will be registered pharmacist and you can be job search. So I just make just one slide. So these are the some admission criteria. As already I told you, if you have to be the bachelor degree and you have to be certain graduate, 65% or something. Then you can eligible for this course. And this course is not just for pharmacists. If you are like physiotherapist or nursing or whatever you did any health related any course, health science, BSc or something, then you want to come to a pharmacist, then you can join this course. In Australia there is a two chance for the person they can enter in pharmacy profession. One is after 12 they have to choose a bachelor degree in pharmacy, or suppose they choose any other course, now they want to come back to this course. So for those only they design this Master of Pharmacy M.Pharm, they can choose this course. So there is they mostly see there is some subject in their bachelor degree like biochemistry, chemistry, pharmacology and physiology. Mostly the physiology, pharmacology, chemistry, chemistry, biochemistry, these four subjects, especially they see statistics and all these, so they can be you can study. Our English requirement I already told you. Man, there is GPA or MCAT or GAMSAT they will ask, but this is not necessary. Some university they give the exemption if you are registered pharmacist in your country. So this course just 2 years and you can work as a part-time as a technician. So it's a very very good this is a very good choice. Those students don't want to give CAP exam. After bachelor degree you can give a CAP exam and you have to come to here. But if you don't want to give a CAP exam and you want to study here in Australia and then you want to be as a registered pharmacist and you can work, then you have to choose this Master of Pharmacy program. This is a 2 year program. Then after that 1 year internship, and then you can be a registered pharmacist. So thank you for watching my videos.